Welcome to the session of Master's Talk. And this Master's Talk, we are going to discuss about the data sufficiency. Data sufficiency, if you will see, then always it is not asking in CAT, but this is one of the good way to develop the understanding of data, which you can say with quantitative knowledge. Means how to use mathematical fundamental knowledge in very precise way that will be helpful to solve your data sufficiency question. Data sufficiency is having some peculiarity compared to other type of questions. Peculiarity means here always it is not necessary you should get the solution or you should get the exact solution. Main thing is there question whatever given, and based on the question whatever a statement or whatever data has given, is the question is solvable or not? That is our prime target. Means many of the times you can take the advantage to solve the data sufficiency question, because maybe you are not able to solve the question, you are not able to get the solution, but if you are able to check it is solvable or not, you will get the marks. Then this is one kind of advantage also. Sometimes it is confusing also. Then again, welcome to the YouTube channel of Parolikho, that we are discussing about the master's talk. And this master's talk we are going to discuss about the data sufficiency. You can say it is a combination of quant and provided a statement or data. Now, without delay, just we'll try to understand what is data sufficiency and what are the factors we have to take care and what are the rules will be there that we have to follow to solve the data sufficiency. Data sufficiency, the question is followed by two statements. That is very ideal scenario for providing the data sufficiency question. Means one question will be there, and based on that, two statements will be followed. We have to check each statement is sufficient to give the answer of question or not. What we have to check? Only sufficiency. Means whatever question is there and whatever a statement is there, based on any particular statement or statement one or statement two, you can take first separately or afterward you can take that together. You have just taken a statement one, whatever given in a statement one, based on that, this question is sufficient to get the answer or not. Means it is not asking you find the solution. Question is asking just to check and tell question is solvable or not. Means this data or this statement is sufficient to solve this question or not. That sufficiency you have to check. Due to name is data sufficiency. Then to solve data sufficiency, three rules we have to always take care, always be careful about these three rules, because these three rules, if you are not aware, then always you will do the mistake. First one, already we have discussed, check the solvability, not to find solutions. Means here it is not required to find the solution of question, only you have to check the solvability. Means it is solvable or not. If it is solvable, we are able to get the unique solution or not. If we are not able to solvable, then both of the statement together is solvable or not. These only we have to just check. After the next most important, always solution should be unique. Unique means it should be single valued, it should not be any hidden value. Second point, if you are able to say clearly, no, it is not solvable, that is also a solution. Hello? Just I'm telling you, between yes and no, generally, our mindset is there. Solution means yes, we are able to solve. Just suppose any question based on the statement one, you can say very unique way, it is not solvable. Then that will be a solution or not. That will also be a solution. Solution means either it is solvable, you are able to say clearly, or you are able to say clearly not solvable. Both of the case, it is a unique solution. Then you can say it is a solution. Not finding a solution is also a solution. But you should be 100% sure you are not able to find the solution. That surety you should give, that is checking the solvability. Next is third rule, no assumption. Don't put from your side assumption, this will be, this will not be, this can be, this cannot be, this house should not be yellow color, this rectangle cannot be 10 by 8. These all are own assumption or own perception or own data, whatever you have imagined in your brain based on the any of the sources, you should not put to solve during the data sufficiency question. Then just suppose if x is equal to 4, x equal to plus minus 2, it is not a unique solution. Just one example I am giving. Like many of the times we will tempted to mark x is equal to 4, okay, x equal to 1, we are getting the solution. Means it is sufficient, but it is not sufficient because you are not getting the unique solution. your condition is to get unique solution. You are getting two solutions, x equal to plus 2 and x equal to minus 2. Means you can say based on that, this you are not getting the unique solution. Means a statement 1 or this statement is not sufficient. X is real number, not imaginary. If we are many of the students or many of the teachers or many of the people I have seen, if once you will just heard real number, means immediately brain will come, oh, it will be integer. Real number means, okay, 3, 4, 5, 6, these all are the real numbers. But we will never thought 3.16 also is a real number, 4.29 also is a real number, and 4.35 also is a real number. Means real number is only meaning which is not imaginary. If it is not imaginary, means real number. Or based on that, we have developed one of the very important tool, real number line, RNL. That is one of the best friend of during your CAT preparation. RNL, simple meaning is there. If any of the number, if you are able to represent on RNL, real number line, that is called real number. If you are not able to represent, that is imaginary number. Means real number is a complete set of that real number line from minus infinity to plus infinity, anything, even irrational number also. Many of the times we'll tell, I think you will think just beside that, irrational number is also a real number, we will able to represent or not. If you are having any doubt, you can see the further video under the quant section, or you can take the video on the parolico.com. Rational number, irrational number, counting number, natural number, whole number, all are a part of real number. Then X is a real number, then we should not restrict ourselves to think only integer. It may be fraction also. Like same way, little bit confusion will be there. Positive solution. Positive solution means it will always start with 1. 0 will not include. If we are telling non-negative solution, then it will start with 0. Same way, negative solution, it will go up to minus 1 only. Non-positive solution, it will be 0 included. But this is a small thing. During solving the data sufficiency question, we will force to do the mistake if we are not enough alert to avoid these mistakes. Now, after giving the question or before giving the question, few directions will be given how to choose the option choices, because option choices will be limited, either A, B, C, D or maybe A, B, C, D, E. Just I have considered here four set of option choices A, B, C, D. Many of the times you will find apart from these four, maybe one more choices will be given. But here I have considered four choices. If answers by using one of the statement alone, but cannot by other alone. Means if two statement given, a statement 1 and a statement 2, any of the statement is sufficient to give the answer, then option A you have to mark. Any of the answer, maybe individually both of the statement are sufficient to give the solution or to check the solvability, then also you will mark A. No, then you have to mark C. Using either a statement alone means both of the statement separately is capable to give the solution, then C. But anyone, maybe a statement 1 or a statement 2 is capable to give the solution, a state, then option A. Now if you are combining both statement 1 and 2 together, then also but cannot be alone. Meaning here, like you checked the statement 1, not possible, a statement 2 not possible, then option A cannot be possible, C cannot be possible. Then only we have to check if you are merging a statement 1 and 2, is it possible or not. Means using both of the statement together and cannot be alone, then you have to put option B. Now another is coming extreme case. If you are putting both of the statement together also, you are not able to solve, cannot be answered, then a statement D. Let's will take one example. This is good question, and this is CAT question, previous year CAT question. And good to understand, because this is question looks very fundamental, but based on that many of the number property we will able to discuss. Then question is telling n plus 2 into n square plus 4n plus 3. This is divisible by 4. Question is telling this is divisible by 4 if n is a natural number. Okay, agree? N is a natural number means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It will go up to plus infinity. It will not go minus infinity side. Hello, I am right. It will not go minus infinity side. Natural number means it will start with 1. It will not start with 0. If it is starting with 0, it will be called whole number. If it is an integer, then we can say it is minus infinity to plus infinity, all the integral number. But it is telling natural number means it will start minimum with 1. Now, a statement 1 is telling n is divisible by 8. A statement 1 is telling n is divisible by 8. Then we have to check if n is divisible by 8, then this n plus 2 into n square plus 4n plus 3 will be divisible by 4 or not. Just we have to check it is divisible or not. We should not find exact what is remainder. It is only we have to check the divisibility. A statement 2 is n plus 1 by 3 is an odd integer. If n plus 1 by 3 is an odd integer, then this statement n plus 2 into n square plus 4n plus 3 is divisible by 4 is valid or not. Just we'll check by one. Before checking through a statement, just we'll rearrange this question. N equal to n plus 2 into n square plus 4n plus 3. Just we will factorize this quadratic equation. It will change into n plus 1 into n plus 3. Then finally you can write n plus 1 into n plus 2 into n plus 3. That n, capital N, is equal to n plus 1 into n plus 2 into n plus 3. Means product of 3 consecutive natural number. That is 100% sure. Means n by 4, if you are dividing, remainder will be always 0. Remainder will be 0. This we have to check. It is given. It is given. It is divisible by 4 if n is a natural number. Then we have to just put the condition for n and we have to check is it valid or not. This one. With condition, with a statement. Now we'll come to the statement 1. N is divisible by 8. If n is divisible by 8, simple way we can write n is equal to 8k. If n is equal to 8k, then this capital N we can write 8k plus 1, 8k plus 2 and 8k plus 3. That is 100% sure. By looking itself, we can say this is odd number, this is even number and this is odd number. These all are the just simple analysis, just common sense. Nothing has given, just based on the odd even pattern, we will able to find it is solvable or not. This is odd, this is even, this is odd. About the odd number, we know only thing it will be either 2n minus 1 and 2n plus 1. Based on that, we will not able to decide it will be divisible by 4 or not, because 4 is a even number. To divisible by 4, we need two number of 2s. We need two number of 2s. How to check two number of 2s are available or not? That information only will be given by even number, because odd number doesn't contain the 2. They will be always as a fractional part of 2, or you can say just remainder part of 2. It will be 2k minus 1 or 2k plus 1. Then we have to just concentrate this number 8k plus 2. These are the common sense, our understanding about deep understanding about the numbers. 8k plus 2 is an even number. Then only we have to check this n is containing only one even number. Then is it sufficient to contain these even number by two number of 2s or not? That only we have to check. Then even number we know it will be a pattern of alternate. It will be either 2k form or 4k form. You can just check. Just we'll take simple table of 2. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. What you are observing? This is 2k form. This is 4k. Again it is 2k. Just we are converting number to variable. Or you can say understanding very basic number table into variable format that we can use in very wide way. Again this is 4k. This is 2k. Means even number. Alternatively, it will change from 2k to 4k, 4k to 2k, 2k to 4k. If it is 4k, then it is without say, we can say 4 is there, means it will be divisible by 4. But if it is 2k format, then depends on the value of k, either it will contain two number of 2s or not. Then chance, what are the chances we got? We have two options here. N, if it is even, then either it will be in the form of 2k1 or 4k1. But 8k plus 2 will be always 2k1 form. Why it will be always 2k1 form? Why it will not 4k1 form? That is only issue here. 8k plus 2, if we are taking 2 as a common, it will become 4k plus 1. Now, if you are putting value of k anything, always it will be in the form of 2k. That is little analysis. Basically, even number will interchange, or it will go from 2k to 4k, 4k to 2k, 2k to 4k, it will alternate, will change the form. But here 8k plus 2, particularly, it will be always in the form of 2k, because 2 is a common. Once we are taking 2 is a common, 4k plus 1 will become an odd number. Odd number starting with 5, nothing else. 1 and 3 is not there. If 2k1 you are taking, it will start with 3. 2k minus 1 you are taking, it will start with 1. 2k minus 3 you are taking, it will start with minus 1. All are odd number. 4k plus 1, it will start with 5. If k equal to 1, it will be 5. K equal to 2, it will be interval of 4. It will not consecutive odd number. If it is 2k plus 1, 2k minus 1, it will be a consecutive odd number. 4k plus 1, 4k minus 1, that is also odd number, but it will be not consecutive, alternate odd number. Then this will be always odd. This is your odd and this is your 2. Means this 8k plus 2 number always will be in the form of 2k1. It will never in the form of 4k1. Means what you got? 4k1 will be never. Means 8k plus 2 will be always 2k1 form. Means we can say n by 4 remainder cannot be 0. No. We are getting clear cut no. We are getting clear cut no. Not here we don't have any dilemma either this number will contain two number of 2s or not. We know 100% now this number cannot contain two number of 2s. Means we can say it is not solvable. Means we are getting very clear and unique solution. Means no, it is also a solution but should be unique. Okay. Now we'll come to the statement 2. Statement 2 is telling n plus 1 by 3 is odd. If n plus 1 by 3 is odd, then n will become 3 into odd minus 1. 3 into odd minus 1, it will be even. Now again, same story. If n is even, then it will become 2k or 4k. Means both of the form will be possible because even number will repeat alternate after 2k to 4k. Means here, both the solution will be possible, either 2k or 4k. Means one of the time it will be divisible by 4. If it is 4k, another time it will not divisible by 4 if it is 2k. Means no unique solution. Means we can say no unique solution. We are getting two solutions. One time it is divisible, one time it will not divisible. Means based on that statement 1 and 2, we can say question can be answered by statement 1 very unique way. It is not divisible by 4 because that number will never contain two number of 2s because that 8k plus 2 number will be always in the form of 2k, then we can say 100% sure this number cannot be divisible by 4. Then question can be answered by a statement 1 but cannot be a statement by a statement 2. Which choice you will put? Choice A. If any of the statement, either a statement 1 or 2 alone is sufficient, then you have to mark option A. Then just I told initially also before starting discussion of this question, these options A, B, C, D may be sometimes given in different format. Maybe sometimes in place of 4 option may be given the 5 option. Be careful, just carefully read all the option choices. And after analyzing the statement 1 and a statement 2, very precise way you choose, it will fall down in which option category, option A, option B, option C, option D or option E. If further you want to learn further about the data sufficiency and you want to practice few more questions, that is further interesting. One question itself was more interesting. But we have not solved any question. We have checked only question is solvable or not. Then of course you can continue to the learn at the rate of parolico.com or you can download the mobile app also. Thank you.